entrepreneurs. Okay, so coach Steve, that's what we're going to do here. The number one attribute of a successful entrepreneur. What do you think the number one attribute is? Yes?
Work ethic.
Work ethic, it's right there. Yes?
A leader.
So they did this research and all these entrepreneurs, and those are on the list, but the number one attribute was persistence. Passion, persistence. So your ability to stick with your idea and to be persistent in spite of all the obstacles. We talk about a three-step process here. It's called DSV. The D stands for dream. You can have a dream. The S stands for struggle. And then the V is victory. Don't expect a quick victory and success in business. And the reason I share the DSV, dream, struggle, victory, is if you know that the struggles are going to come, you can be prepared for them psychologically. The struggles will come. Every single entrepreneur that was successful had to overcome an entrepreneurial struggle. So be prepared for them. Some people get a quick success, but it's dream in your mind, that dream, that vision. Then the struggle, and victory is around the corner. Okay? There was a story of this high school student that wanted to be really successful. And he was walking down the road in the woods, and he found this path. And on the path was this old man sitting there meditating. And he asked him, he stopped, and he said, "Can you tell me, where is the road to success?" He said, "The road to success is just up ahead." So the high school student is walking down the road, looking forward to the road to success, and he turned the corner, and he didn't see there was this big pit, and he fell into this pit, and he was struggling, and he was trying to get out, cupping his arms and everything, and it was the most frustrating thing in the world. And he got out of the thing, and he was so mad at that old man that he went back and he said, "Hey, I asked you, where is the road to success? And you sent me this way, and I fell in the pit." And the old man looked at him and said, "The road to success is just beyond the pit." You see, that pit was part of the struggle. Victory was beyond. So the question is, when you fall in that pit, are you going to stop? Are you going to go back and complain? Or are you going to get ready to know that victory and success is just beyond the pit? Okay, so be ready for that. So we're going to learn a lot of things here. I don't know if any of you believe this or not, but 1 week can change your life if you want it to. Okay, this isn't, there'll be some time, it gets a little boring, but this isn't about school. This is about each and every single one of you and what you can do to change your life. Let me ask you a question. Who here had a choice in where and when they were born? Did anybody have a choice and where and when they were born? No. We didn't have a choice. Right? Our parents, we were born somewhere, in some neighborhood to some set of parents. So that's the environment we were born into. There's nothing we can do about that past. Zero. We cannot change it. What can we do that we can control and change? What we can control and change is how we think, act, and behave from this point forward in our life. That's what we're in charge of, okay? Yeah, your parents tell you what to do, teachers tell you what to do. Maybe you do it, maybe you don't do it. But it's really up to you what you want to do. So if you put your mind to it and you focus. So this week can have an impact on you. We have a group of many different people here from different countries, different backgrounds, different ethnicities. But while we're here, I don't know how you feel about other people from different places, but while we're here, we're all going to get along. And we're going to respect and appreciate the differences, because when you build a company, when you build a team, you don't want everybody that's thinking just like you on that team. You want people that think different, that act different, different cultures, different ethnicities. Each will bring something different to the table. So I know most of you probably do already respect differences. And while we're here, we will respect them. We won't have any problems. Is that correct? That's correct. And be on the lookout for who you want to recruit on your team. I'll give you an example. Who here is really good with math? Who loves numbers, math? Who are the math people? We need to see these math people. Okay, raise your hand really high. Because I'm telling you why. When you're building a team, Okay, you got a bunch of creative entrepreneurs, you got some crazy idea, we're gonna put something together. We need these numbers people on our team to help us get all the numbers ready to say, can we do what we need to do? So you're gonna need a finance person, you're gonna need a creative person, an organization person. So you're gonna meet different people during this time as you put the teams together. And we're gonna start some businesses. And the opportunity to win $1,000. $1,000 first place, $500 second, $250 third. Do we have anybody here that has won the business plan competition cash before? Oh, Catherine, yes. Miss Catherine, she won last year. What school do you go to?
Beckman
High School, first place team. You'll see Jewel running around here. Where's Jewel? Oh, there she is. She won the business plan competition the year before. First place team. And then, so these are two winners. Two of 100 winners, because this room is all winners. We know that. And then on the way in, when you registered, Bailey is at Michigan State University. He was part of Joel's team that won.